Hello children, I hope all of you are fine and are taking very good care of yourselves. So welcome once again to your social studies class. In today's session, we shall be learning about lines of longitudes. So if you remember, in your previous session, you had learnt about latitudes. So let us start with the lesson. Now if you look at this picture, you can see there is a line in the center, prime meridian is written over there, and you have two hemispheres, the eastern and the western hemisphere. If you remember, when we learnt about latitudes, there was a line in the middle at 0 degree, which is called the equator. The equator divides the earth into two equal halves, that is the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. Similarly, the prime meridian, it is the most important line of longitude which divides the earth into two hemispheres, the eastern and the western hemisphere. So let us see how this takes place. Now you had learnt, you know, that the lines of latitude are called parallels of latitude. You must be wondering that why are they called parallels of latitude? Yes, because they run parallel to each other. But when we come to lines of longitude, we don't call them lines of longitude, we call them meridians of longitude. See, the first point says the lines that run from the North Pole to the South Pole are of equal length. If you remember, lines of latitude are not equal in length. Their length varies as they move towards the poles. From the equator towards the north or the south pole, the length of the line starts decreasing. But the longitudes which are running from north pole to the south pole are all equal in length, and they are 360 in number. In the previous image you saw, there were two hemispheres, 180 degree east and 180 degree west. They are called meridians of longitude. This you will not find in your lesson. Why? Because each line of longitude divides the earth into two equal halves. But this is not the case in latitudes. Latitude, only the equator divides the earth into two equal halves. But the other lines, they do not divide it into equal halves. But longitude, each one of them divides the earth into two equal halves. The line of longitude which passes through Greenwich near London in the UK is called the prime meridian. And one very important thing you need to keep in mind is that the prime meridian is also an imaginary line like the equator. You will not find any line drawn on the earth. Okay. The prime meridian divides the earth into two equal halves, the eastern hemisphere and the western hemisphere. Now, like the equator, the prime meridian also has a 0 degree, and this is 0 degree longitude. And from it we can count 180 degrees eastward and 180 degrees westward. And it is very interesting to know that both the lines, they merge, 180 degree east and 180 degrees west, they are on the same line. Okay, all this is, you can find also in your book. Okay, the longitude of a place is followed by the letter E for the east and W for the west. So like when you were doing, you learnt about latitudes, there was written N and S, no? Like you have the Tropic of Cancer at 23.5 degree north, the Tropic of Capricorn in 23.5 degree south. We have, as we have northern and southern hemispheres, so for latitudes we write north and south. But in the case of longitudes, we write E and W. E stands for east and W stands for west. Now here you can see the grid. Now what is a grid? The latitudes and longitudes which intersect each other at right angles form a network called grid. A grid helps in locating places. So you can see in this picture there are lines of latitude also. You can see the equator, you can see the prime meridian, you can see lines of longitude as well as latitude. Now both these lines intersect, they meet at a certain point, and when they intersect each other at right angles, they form a network which is called a grid. A grid helps in locating places. So you must be wondering, how can a grid help in locating places? Suppose you want to find out Delhi. Now in your book it's given Delhi, any place. It can be any place you want to find out where it is located. Now for Delhi it is 28 degree north latitude and 77 degree east longitude. So on this grid you will have to find a point. Okay, you will just see all the lines of latitude and find where there is 77 degree east, and then you will have a look at the longitude is 77 degree east and 28 degree north latitude. So where these two points will meet, that means 28 degree north and 77 degree east, where these two lines intersect, there will be only one point where both will be meeting. There cannot be different points, no, because if you change little bit also, the measurement will differ. So that exact point is the place where Delhi is located. That way you can locate it very easily. This method is very useful and it helps to locate any place in the world, on the globe or on the map. So in this way, what happens when you go to higher classes, no, they will tell you to find out, locate places. The latitude and longitude is given and it becomes very easy in that way to locate these places. So this is all for this lesson. So the major points what we learnt is, we learnt about the shape of the earth. The earth is round in shape, slightly flat at the poles, and it bulges at the equator. Then we learnt about a globe, which is a model of the earth. We learnt about axis, the line that joins the north pole and the south pole, and it is tilted at an angle of 23.5 degrees. The equator, which divides the earth into northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere, and the lines running parallel to the equator are called lines of latitudes or parallels of latitudes. In today's session you learnt about lines that run from north pole to south pole are of equal length and they are called lines of longitudes. The line of longitude which passes through Greenwich near London in UK is the prime meridian. And in the end you learnt about the grid, which helps in locating places. So this is all for this lesson. At the end of the chapter you will find there's a question given about the difference between latitudes and longitudes. I'm very sure that all of you by now you must be knowing the difference between latitudes and longitudes. Very simple, latitudes vary in length, longitudes, all of them are of equal length. Okay, latitudes run parallel to each other, but longitudes are not parallel to each other. Fine. And now you will go through, if you cannot remember, you will go through the entire video and find out the points and write down in your rough copy the difference between latitudes and longitudes. So now we will be moving towards the exercises. Now you can see the fill in the blanks. The earth is dash in shape, it is round in shape. The end point at the top of the globe is called the North Pole, and at the bottom of the globe is called the South Pole. Dash is an imaginary line that divides the earth in two halves. So which is that line? Equator. And the line of longitude we did just now, which passes through dash in UK is called the, so the line which passes through Greenwich is called the prime meridian. Longitudes to the east of Greenwich are called east longitudes, and to the west are called west longitudes. You have to match the following. The Arctic Circle is 66.5 degrees north. All these are important lines of latitudes, children. The Tropic of Cancer is at 23.5 degrees north. The Antarctic Circle is at 66.5 degrees south, and the Tropic of Capricorn is at 23.5 degrees south. Write T for true and F for false. You can see on the screen I have written the complete thing, so you will also write the full thing. TRUE and FALSE. The earth is flat at the poles and round at the equator. This is true. It is an oblate spheroid. I had told you it is flat at the poles and round at the equator. Inflatable globes are very handy. Yes, this is also true, because if you can inflate them and then you remove the air, no, and you can carry them anywhere. Number three, axis is an imaginary line. True. The equator divides the earth into two equal halves. True again. The equator is the smallest longitude. False. It is a latitude and it is the biggest latitude. So number five will be false, children. And you should know why you are writing it as false, because you should know the correct answer. The lines of longitude are 360 in number. True. The prime meridian also divides the earth into two equal halves. True. The latitudes and longitudes together form a network called grid. Again. Now tick the correct answer. We just missed out on that. The line of longitude which passes through Greenwich is called prime meridian. A globe is map or sketch. No, it is a model of the earth. The total number of meridians is 360. The equator is 0 degree latitude, not longitude. 0 degree longitude is prime meridian. The Tropic of Cancer is located at 23.5 degree north. So this is all for now. I hope you have understood the lesson well. If you have any doubts, you can please watch your video again and again and clarify all your doubts. Thank you. Take good care of yourself till we meet again.